There are two simple ways that we use RSI. And the first one is just by simply observing the range that it's in. So in the same way that we look at price and try to identify the direction of the underlying trend in a very overly simplistic way, some might say, we're doing the same thing with momentum. So when prices are in an uptrend, making higher highs, higher lows, clearly not in a downtrend, what you're gonna see is momentum get overbought. Momentum's gonna get above 70 on those rallies within an uptrend. But obviously, nothing goes straight up. So what you're also going to see during those corrections in price, momentum is gonna stay above 30. You're not gonna get oversold readings in an uptrend. So in rallies, you're gonna get overbought. In corrections, you're gonna stay above oversold conditions. That's what we call momentum being in a bullish range and confirming that yes, indeed, price is in an uptrend. Now, if you're looking at a chart and you think that the price is in an uptrend and going higher, and then on one of the corrections, momentum falls below 30, that's a heads up that something's wrong. You probably need to reevaluate that bullish thesis. Also, in some of the strongest uptrends, what you're gonna see is momentum is gonna stay above 50. It's not even gonna get close to falling below 30. Those are the strongest markets for sure. And then it works the other way around. In bearish downtrends in price, you're gonna get momentum in a bearish range. And as you can see, this is very easy. All you gotta do is take a quick look. The same way we identify the direction of price, we can see the same thing in momentum. So if prices are in a strong downtrend, making lower lows, lower highs, clearly going from the upper left to the lower right, momentum is going to get oversold on sell-offs. You're gonna get new lows in price and momentum's gonna fall below 30. However, when prices rally within a downtrend, because obviously nothing goes straight down, you're gonna get those corrective rallies. Momentum is never gonna get overbought. In those corrective rallies, you're gonna fail right around the 60, 65 level, and the worst markets, the strongest downtrends, stay below 50. So we're gonna get oversold in downtrends, not get overbought. And in uptrends, we're gonna get overbought, but we're not gonna get oversold. And that's how we look at ranges in the market.